Introduction to Addition.
Hello friends, I am the Parrot and I welcome you to today's lesson. Come on, let us see what are you going to learn in today's lesson. What happens if you add one more thing to a given thing and how to add numbers? Today Pinky's mother is unwell, so Pinky has thought of helping her mother set the plates in the kitchen. She picked up one plate and set it carefully on the shelf. Very carefully, she picked up one more plate and set that plate on the shelf too. So friends, how many plates are there on the shelf? That's right, one plate and one more plate is two plates. She saw one more plate and thought of setting that too on the shelf. There were two plates already. After setting one more plate, how many plates are there on the shelf? That's right, two plates and one more plate is three plates. Which means in total there are now three plates on the shelf. So friends, you saw that adding more things to the given things increases their number. At school too, Pinky helps her teacher set things. In today's art class, she distributed color boxes to everyone. Let us see what is happening in today's class. Today, all students have to make a drawing of trees. So Pinky thought of making drawing of a jungle.
At first she drew one tree because she had to make a dense forest, so she drew another tree.
Pinky, what have you drawn in the picture?
At first I drew one tree, then I drew another tree. So in total I drew two trees.
If you draw another tree, then how many trees will be there?
See this, teacher, two trees and one more tree. So now in total, there are three trees.
Very good, Pinky. Okay, suppose if I draw one more tree along with these three trees, so how many trees will be there in total?
Three trees and one more tree. So in total, there are four trees.
Very good, Pinky. Okay, if I make one more tree along with these four trees, then how many trees will be there?
Four trees and one more tree. Then in total there are five trees.
Very good, Pinky. Come on, now complete your drawing.
So children, can you also add things like Pinky and tell their total number? That's all for today. In this video we learned adding more things to the given things increases their number.
In the next video, we will see some interesting examples of addition.
Till then, bye friends.
Examples of addition, part 1.
So children, in the previous video, you drew several trees one by one in a forest and counted them in total. Come on, let us see some more examples in this video. Today, Chotu wants to stitch a few buttons on his shirt. He already stitched three buttons and then he stitched one more button. Three buttons and one button is four buttons. Now Chotu has stitched one more button on his shirt. So four buttons and one more button is five buttons. Now count and tell how many buttons are stitched in Chotu's shirt. Yes, you are absolutely correct. Total of five buttons. Through hard work, Chotu stitched one more button after five buttons. Now think and answer, total how many buttons are stitched on Chotu's shirt? Yes, you are correct. Five buttons and one button.
There are a total of 6 buttons stitched on Chotu's shirt. Good work! In the end, Chotu stitched 3 more buttons on his shirt. So now there are 6 buttons and 3 more buttons. Now what is the total number of buttons stitched on his shirt? Yes, 9 buttons. So children, I hope you had fun seeing the examples of addition. Even you look at things around you and you must try to add numbers to find the total number. That's it for today. In this video, we saw examples of addition in which we added more numbers to the given numbers. In the next video, we will see some more examples of addition and some common mistakes. Till then, goodbye friends.
Examples of addition, part 2.
So children, in the previous video you saw how we added numbers to more numbers.
In this video we will see some more examples and understand where all did Chotu make mistakes while doing addition. Pinky and Chotu are playing the small snakes and ladder game because it has numbers only from 1 to 9. In this, two dice are thrown in turns and by adding numbers of both dice, one has to move the piece to the correct number.
The one who reaches at 9 first wins the game.
Let us see how Chotu and Pinky are enjoying this game.
May I roll the dice first?
Yeah, sure. Then add the numbers on both the dice correctly and move your piece forward.
Okay. Chotu rolls both the dice. Just see, 2 is written on one dice and 3 on the other.
Chotu, what is the total when you add 2 and 3?
When we add 2 and 3, we get 4.
This is incorrect, Chotu. Think again and explain how did you count.
1 and 2, that's the number on the first dice. 2, 3 and 4. Do you think Chotu's method to add the numbers is correct? Come on, let us look at this carefully.
Chotu, 2 has come on one dice, so move your piece forward to 2 places. And after that, move your piece as many numbers forward as the number on other dice. Because here we got the number 3 from the second dice. From 2, we will go 3 places forward. Here is the first step. Here is the second step. And here is the third step.
Oh yes, when we add 2 and 3, we get total of 5.
Absolutely correct. It's my turn now.
Now Pinky rolls both the dice. 5 comes on the first dice and 4 comes on the second dice.
It is 5 and 4. First, I am moving my piece 5 places forward. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. My piece is on number 5. So now I will move it 4 places forward. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now my piece has come to number 9.
That means adding 5 and 4 gave us 9. Is that right, Pinky?
Yes, Chotu. You are absolutely correct. Hooray! I won the game. Come on, let's start again. This time, properly add the numbers on both dice and move your piece forward.
So children, I hope you had fun watching the game of snakes and ladder. You too can now add 2 numbers like Chotu and Pinky, isn't it? That's all on this topic. In this video, we learned that to add any 2 numbers, we need to start adding the next number after the first number. I hope that you have understood this topic properly. Goodbye, friends.